what the impact of these databases are that these are professionally determined databases. These are the experts in the field who are deciding what is quality in their profession. The techniques that are used are very rigorous. The analysis is very statistically rigorous. There's slightly different, without going into it, there's slightly different methodology for New York State than for SDS, but both use very well documented, very rigorous, and it's all in the public domain. Everything that they do is disclosed either in articles or on websites, et cetera, or both. And the SDS has also begun a program of voluntary public reporting, and about two-thirds to maybe even three-quarters, a little bit shy of that, I think, of the adult cardiac surgical programs now publicly report. So now bringing it bringing it into the current realm here, the importance of these databases is that we can use the information both sides. We can use it professionally in order to identify opportunities for improvement in our work, and we can also use it to inform the public as to the quality of the work that we're doing. The star rating system in the STS is based on a three-level, very rigorous scale to determine if results are better than, worse than, or approximately the same as the mean of the entire sample. The criteria are rigorous. So only 5 to 10% of programs actually achieve a three-star rating, and only about 5 to 10% of programs achieve have a one-star rating. What the intention here is not like U.S. News and World Report, that if you have 100 programs, they're going to tell you, well, this is one, this is two, this is three, this is four. Because professionally, that's not actually so meaningful. And there may be tremendous variability from year to year in different programs, depending upon the volume, et cetera. And so what the societies are interested in is that the information that goes out to the public is very well vetted, it's very solid, and it is readily understandable. So what this means for us is that it's a tremendous honor that in the recent report, which will actually not hit the public reporting website for several months, because there's a lag in the logistics of it, but the report has been officially released as of this week, is that in the five areas where there is a rating system, which comprise about 80% of the operations that cardiac surgeons do in the country. In our particular case, it's actually a little bit less than that because we do a lot of advanced things. We do a lot of aortic work. We do a lot of transplant and ventricular assist devices, and those sorts of things are not yet, there hadn't been developed the statistical methodology to risk adjust in those areas. So that's a field in evolution. But nonetheless, for the more common operations, coronary artery bypass surgery and valvular surgery, there are five general categories, and three of those five we had three-star ratings. So, that's less than 2% of programs in the country actually have that that distinction. And similarly, I should note that we do a very large volume of congenital heart surgery. We're one of the top five volume congenital programs in the country. And amongst those programs, the rigor of risk adjusting in congenital is extremely complex. But without going into that, there is a rating system whereby operations are put into different risk categories. And in the highest risk categories, we have some of the most outstanding results in the nation. particularly in those high-risk categories. So, and also on the New York State side, we were the only program, the only congenital program in New York State that had a risk-adjusted mortality that was less than expected. So on both the adult side and on the congenital side, and both in the SDS and in the New York State metric, we had a very strong endorsement for the quality of our work. Is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. And you know, one of the things about the SDS database, it may be a little bit onerous because it's so big. There's a lot of information there, but all of the metrics, the SDS has gone to the trouble that all of the metrics that are used to judge quality there have been submitted and endorsed by the National Quality Forum, which shows that they have gone through the rigor of reliability and validity of the metric, and it's been accepted not only in the cardiac surgical world, but in the professional world itself. Unlike New York State, that database also introduces not only mortality, but complications and other process measures into their quality metrics. And so even though we did very well, our scores are not perfect, and that you know leaves a lot of opportunities for improvement, which we do work on. So that it's the information is very helpful to us in terms of not only assessing where we stand, but also helping us to improve. But it also provides information, meaningful information to the public so that they know that there is a professionally vetted source of information about quality in cardiac surgery, and they don't have to rely on, you know, seven different schemes from different places in order to try to figure out where they can get good care.